I have not hold, Mr. Chairman, that I have not seen the rule, nor have I spoken with anyone concerning what the rule would look like other than as it pertains to the agenda that's put forward here this evening. Yesterday or day four, I'm lost in time now. I know you put forward a put down of the previous question. My dear friend, the ranking member raised the question about it. I then took it upon myself to do the added research. The previous question has been an ironclad rule. Never in the history of this institution, under Republicans or Democrats, has the previous question been taken away from the bodies and the people in this body. I hope this rule does not do that. Now, I grew up around people who, some of them, con artists. I had carnivals come through town, as some of you may have, and they always had some of the biggest con artists in the world working in some of those carnivals, as entertaining as they were. But I learned early how to spot a con. I live in South Florida. That's one of the scam capitals of our nation. I moved there 50 years ago. I learned early how to spot a scam. During my time here in Congress, I've seen and once in a while have participated in all kinds of political gimmicks. I've seen them all, at least until I got to this. So I learned early how to spot a political gimmick. But I now am getting a new lesson from y'all. And that's a gimmick wrapped in a scam inside a con. I guess you could call it a gimmick-con scam. Perhaps brought here by the reader the other day in the other body of Sam, I am. Please tell the senator from Texas, and I'll tell you that what you're doing ain't going to work. I yield back.
The gentleman yields back his time. The gentleman from Georgia is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I just had two questions. Mr.